Welcome to Soft Reviewed. In this video, I'll be resuming from where we left off. In the last video, we were about to create an image of a car. And now let's start. I'll just show you how to use this prompt generator. I'll show you like how to convert a small idea into a good prompt using this ideate function for prompt generation. So you can select the number of prompts that you want. For this example, like we can select like 6. So my basic idea will be like a Lamborghini coming out from smoke with very bright RGB colors. So this is like a small idea of mine and I just want to visualize it and to make it an image. So let's just ideate it by clicking on that button. And now it's coming up with 6 prompts since we selected 6 prompts. So we have like this many suggestions from the AI. A Lamborghini emerging from a cloud of vibrant swirling smoke in bright RGB color radiating in the darkness. A Lamborghini speeding out of a fog of bright neon colored smoke. Its body illuminated by kaleidoscopic of RGB color. A Lamborghini basting out of a blowing cloud of smoke, glowing with a dazzling array of RGB colors. From a vibrant swirling smoke, body illuminated by a spectrum of Lamborghini emerging from a... I like this one because, and if you want you can also edit this and add further more details to it. And for example, I'll just give this prompt like ultra realistic 8K. Can just give a comma. So now let's click on just generate. Once we edited the prompt with our requirements, just click on generate, then it will directly start generating that image. As you can see here, it selected the Leonardo select image. So as you can see, this is the image that it came up with. Now if we want, we can generate 4 variations of this. We just click on generate and generate. This looks really great. Now let's get this scale to 15 and let's make the step count to 60 because I want as much details as I possibly can. So just clicking on generate again. So these are some of the images. So as you can see, the details are really high with this. Let's just click on this one. This is the one I really liked. And let's take this to our editing canvas. So we'll directly take to our canvas and try to extend this image. Like I just want to make this as a wallpaper for my desktop. So what I can do is like you need to give the AI the information that it requires to actually extend the image. So as much you can just keep it like half so that it knows like what it needs to work with. So for here you can actually keep the same prompt that you used. So in order to do that, we need to copy. Let's go back and just get the prompt. And now let's copy the same prompt that we gave. And now let's just try to extend this image so that it can be used for our desktop. It will give you like 4 options. You can select from that. This is the one I think that suits. I'll accept it. And now that's done. Now let's do this portion. Let's click on generate. you have four options. You can see that by clicking on this arrow, and can select the one you like. For I think this looks more realistic, I can just click on accept, and I can do the same here as well.
We also have the function to lock it so that it will not move. So I'll just unlock it and just like that. I think this is more realistic. Okay, that was the first one. I think I'll stick with this one. Just click on accept and I'll move downward. Do the same, I'll generate this as well. This one better, so I'll accept this and it's done. You can also go and actually change this.
That's the outpainting. So this is our final image. Now if you want, you can just pan this using this button. And you can also zoom in and zoom out using this button. You can also use stable diffusion 1.5 and 2.1, and you can play with this and see which one works for you. You can also increase the step count and guidance scale so that it will stick to your prompt more accurately. And you also have the option to draw a mask. For this example, I'll just draw one mask, and you can just increase the size of this using this one, and I'll just draw a triangle cone here. I want a traffic cone, so and that's the traffic cone that I want to generate. And let's just say like add a traffic cone. So that's our traffic cone there.
So we have one traffic cone there. You can just it once more.
You can always play around with it till you get the desired result. As you can see, I have this erase button can also erase mask and erase the images. There is a select button there which you can adjust to erase the image or just the mask. Now I am just erasing that image, and you can also do undo and redo the changes. And if you click on generate, it will start generating the image. And so you can see it's included a traffic cone with the regenerated image, since we have that prompt there in that prompt section. Now you can mask it, and you can also have a small dot there which I can use that erase tool to remove that small mask. And you can like fine-tune the mask just like that. And now let's again see if we can generate a cone, and again it generated some other colored cone. And let's see if we can generate any variations of it. So you can see it generated variations. And if you like that, you can just accept it, or you can again keep on generating different cones till you find the one you like. So I just think this will work for now, and we can just accept it. And the other change that I want to show you is like in painting, The extending image part is called outpainting, and if you want to make changes inside your image, that's called inpainting. Now using this inpainting feature, we can just create a mask because we only want to make changes there. So we are just instructing the AI to only make changes there, and after making the mask, we can actually like write our prompt here. In this, I want to actually change the tire color to red, and let's give the prompt and adjust the frame just like that, and let's click on generate and see the output that it's generated. See, it changed the tire color, but it's not red. Maybe I'll have to actually insist more on the prompt. Maybe I can say like the specific car name, like Lamborghini red tire. Maybe that will emphasize to change the color to red. Now let's click on just generate. So if you are not getting the desired result, you can always play with the prompt and keep on changing the prompt, and you can also use the guidance scale. As you can see, that's a red alloy. I think I like that one. I'll stick with that, and that looks really nice. So that's how you change the parts of the images. The imagination is your limit here, and if you can imagine, you can actually make that happen even without any Photoshop skills or any editing skills. I don't know Photoshop myself, but I am just really in love with this software because it enables me to actually imagine and create images just by thinking about it, and if you can just type a prompt and you can make the changes. So that's the software in a nutshell, and I hope you liked it. And if once everything is done, you can always download that artwork and just download, and let's just open it and see our final image with the red alloys and the cone beside it. I'll also show you an upscaled image of the image that we worked with now, and I just clicked on upscale, and let's see the fully upscaled version. As you can see, this is the upscaled version and this is the original image. So there is a huge difference in detail, and let's just download and just zoom in, and as you can see, that's the image. It looks really nice. So that's how the inpainting and outpainting works in Leonardo. Hope this video was helpful. If you learned something new, please don't forget to click on the like button and subscribe for more future videos. And thank you for watching. Have a great day.